Hey guys, welcome to this video on how to differentiate using the chain rule. At this point, you should know how to take the derivative of functions like these are somewhat straightforward. We can use the power rule, the quotient rule, or the product rule. But what about a function like this? Well, using the definition of a derivative to take the derivative, we get now, if we were to use the power rule to try and take the derivative, we would get now, these two functions may look similar, but as you can see, they're not. We have different numbers here in the numerator. We could use the definition of a derivative to take the derivative of a function every time. But if we take a close look at this function, we could say that f of t is equal to, let's say, square root of g of t. And then our g of t is equal to everything on the inside here. Then what we could do is write it as a composition function. Well, this sets us up then to be able to use the chain rule. There are two types of notations in which you can choose to use the chain rule, and I'll list both. Let's say you have two functions. Which would then make the derivative of z of x the other type of notation is called Leibniz notation. If you have the function y is equal to f of u and u is equal to g of x, then the derivative of y is in this video, I'll use this first type of notation or the prime notation. Now, let's look at how to apply the chain rule. Now, we've already looked at this problem and figured out which two functions are needed for the composition. So we can go ahead and take the derivatives of these two functions. Then, using the chain rule, we get one thing that you'll notice, and I think is super helpful, is I always write out the two functions that my original function is made up of, and then I take their derivatives and write that out. This helps me to keep track of my work. All right, now let's take a look at another example. What two functions is this function made up of? Well, we have 7 times everything on the inside, all to the power of 6. Then we have the inside function here, which is 5h to the third plus cosine of h. So we can break this up into two separate functions. I'm going to set f of h equal to my outside function here. So that's 7g of h, because that's the inside, all to the power of 6. Then I'm going to set g of h equal to my inside function, which is 5h to the third plus cosine of h. Now we take the derivative of our two functions. We are now ready to use the chain rule. Another helpful way to think through how to use and apply the chain rule is this. The derivative of the outside function times the inside function left alone times the derivative of the inside function. Now, let's walk through that. B prime of h is equal to the derivative of the outside function, so that's our f prime of h here, so that's 42, times the inside function left alone. So that's our g of h right here, so that's 5h to the third plus cosine of h all to the fifth power. Now, we have to multiply times the derivative of the inside function. So that's our g prime of h here. So it's 15h squared minus sine of h. And there's your answer. Remember, when using the chain rule, try and identify two functions within the original function. Multiply times the derivative of that outside function times the inside function left alone times the derivative of the inside function. I hope that this video has been helpful for you. For further help, be sure to check out more of our videos by subscribing to our channel below. See you guys next time.